Welcome back to another video. Hope you are having a great day, and hopefully it will get a bit better after I share with you how we can accomplish this type of image just by using our imagination, putting it to text, and with the help of AI, we will get this kind of image and a few others that I just finished doing right over here, totally free and without limitations. And if you are looking for a tool that will accomplish this, probably you have searched for some solutions and what you did find is that you have to pay or you have some huge limitations. This one doesn't have any limitations and free at all. Now I'm using this new computer right over here, which is the Asus ZenBook S13 OLED, which is the slimmest ultrabook with OLED screen on the planet right now. If the review is not out yet, I will leave a link down below as soon as it comes out. And if you are watching this video before, just wait a couple of videos and I will share all the info with you. It has Windows 11 Pro, but if you are watching this video on your computer and you still haven't activated, don't forget to check out KeysFan, where you can find budget official OEM keys at an affordable price. And with the coupon code that you can see on screen and down below in the video description, you will get a big discount, and it's totally worth it to have Windows activated with all the updates and whatnot on your machine. Now, that being said, let's go take a look at the screen. Now, this was one of the latest images that I did create. I will explain in just a few moments some of the glitches right over here, some of the limitations that I did find. I also created this one, which is awesome. This one right over here, which is cute. Not my kind of drawing, but really nice. This one, I love this one right over here. And this one, does it look like someone that you know? Probably yes. Now, the site that we need to go is to Glyph, and it is right over here. You can check here. I will leave the link down below in the video description as well, because when I do search for Glyph, we will have a lot of results, and so that you don't lose time, I will leave it down below. Once you get to the website, you just need to create an account or sign in with your Google account, which is what I have right over here. And basically, that is it. We are ready to start using. And we will find a lot of options here. So it's not just a text to AI image creator. We have some templates that we can use created by the community, and you can also create your own and then share with your community right over here. So just for example, we will go to the build, which is right over here, but let's go to the glyphs. If we go to image generators, for example, we will see that I have used this one. Actually, I was the last one to use. I did create these two based on my own picture. I just needed to select my picture and then select if I wanted beautiful, which I did on this one, and it was not. And this one I did write normal, and the result was this. So you can write whatever you want and you will have a different result. But you have a lot of templates right over here that you can use. Besides image generators, there are a lot more right over here. On the comics, I also created and shared with the community this one right over here, which is of a fisherman. So we just tell the story and it will create a page of a comic book, which is really awesome as well. Now, if we take a look right over here, for example, and if we check the source, we will see that we have a lot of situations here. And you will understand a little bit better this when I show you the part of the build. Although this one is a complex one, you can create simpler ones and then grow with the tests that you do. Now let's go back and let's go to the simple things, and let's go to the home page once again. So we will have also options for selfies. If you want a courtroom style and then just with a selfie, you can choose, and a lot more. So just explore that. Now, on the other hand, if you want to create images like this one right over here, we just need to go to the build, and then on the build we need to press on start adding and select this one right over here, which is the image spell. And as you saw previously when I did share the source of one of the templates, it has a lot of things here. We are just going to use the image, which is text to image. Now, if I go back here, I just want to explain the kind of results that you can expect, which are awesome, but with some limitations. If we look at this image, which by the way, we can write in English, Portuguese, or any other language, then it will understand. So it's okay if you are not native English, like I'm not, I'm Portuguese. But if we look at the image, I don't know if this is a dog or a goat, something like that. And as you can see, there are legs getting in the car. Other than that, the image looks awesome. I love this kind of image. But just to show you what I did ask was a rat hunting a cat, hunting a chicken, hunting a dog in a street. And I did start with a simple thing, which was a rat hunting a cat. And by some reason, what happened was that the AI did not go to the rat hunting a cat. It gave me always an image that gave me the intention that was the cat hunting the rat, which is the normal thing, but I wanted the inverse. So expect some limitations right over here. And one of the things that I did select as well, which I would suggest for you to try, there are several engines that we can use, and we can select right over here, image generation model. Now I'm using DALL-E 3. As you know, it's a service that we need to pay to use it. We want to use it intensively. But here we are using DALL-E 3 via OpenAI for free. So I do believe that the Glyph platform has this service, and then we have the opportunity to use it for free, which is awesome. But you can select any of these right over here. All of them are really nice, but I do prefer DALL-E, but it's something that you just test it out and see for yourself. And then we select what kind of image. For me, I prefer cinema or landscape, which is great. And this was the story of this image. I did try and try and try. And one curious thing is that there is no such a second image the same. So if I press right over here, what happens is that it will give me a different result, a different image every time that we press the button. And there we go, a different kind of image. In this case, it's a mixture of cats and rats, and then a rat, a chicken, and a dog. Something really crazy. I like this kind of drawing, mixture of reality with drawing. So really, really nice. But the message is that save the image that you record, because there won't be a second same image. And that was it. Now, if we look at this one, the thing that I did right here was only monster, as you can see. So I was very vague. On the other hand, right over here, I did write a few more things. There is an example that I can share with you as well, where I did start with a man with a suit and a pumpkin head, and then I selected glasses, and then I selected something else, and by the end I was with a person with a suit with a pumpkin head in a classroom. So that was a great result as well. I also select a man in a suit in a skateboard, which is something not very usual, but I wanted to see what I could get, and I got different results, which were really awesome as well. So if we are just subjective, like I was right over here, a monster, basically it will give me whatever the AI. But if I want something very specific, a red monster with green eyes and something like that, then it will give me a different result. This one actually was a lot better than what I was expecting. Here I just selected Father Christmas, the same that I did right over here, and it gave me completely different results. And if I keep on trying, it will give me different results and different results until I find what I want. This one was the one that I show you, where I did select my picture right over here, this one right over here, and then it gave me this result first, and the second result was this one right over here. And as we are on Christmas, let's select Father Christmas went fishing. And I will explain why I did select this. Bam, there we go, a really cool image as well. Now, I did select this because I just recorded a video in my Portuguese channel, and I did select exactly this in Portuguese. And I'll show you the image that I got there, which was a bit better than this one, probably. But this one is also really, really cool, well designed, and that kind of image that I really love. We can see that it's not real. It is basically on that edge between the real and unreal that looks and feels really awesome. And basically, this is it for the sharing of today. Now, it is completely free to use. It has a lot of tools to explore, so I believe that you will have a few hours of learning and testing, and you will laugh a lot in that process. At least this is my hope. I would love to hear from you on the comment down below before you use it and after you use it, your experience and what you feel about AI in general and on Glyph in particular. Hopefully the video was helpful to enhance your day and your imagination in terms of drawing with AI assistant. If that was the case, don't forget that usual thumbs up over there, which is really appreciated on this side of the screen. My name is Huerto George, and as always, I'll see you on the next one.